Oh, clear ahead, Captain. Sensors indicate zero registered.
Forward readings, Mr. Spock.
Gravimetric reading, no significant change. Zero space density.
Ahead warp factor 3, Mr. Sulu. Colony Beta 6 wants their supplies. We'll get across this void in a hurry.
Void? Stardust. The word conjures up pictures of dunes, oases, mirages.
Sunlight, palm tree. We're 900 light years from that kind of desert, Bones.
The precise meaning of the word desert is a waterless, barren wasteland. I fail to understand your romantic nostalgia for such a place.
Doesn't surprise me, Mr. Spock. I can't imagine a mirage ever disturbing those mathematically perfect brainwaves of yours.
Thank you, Dr. McCoy. Moving on schedule into quadrant 904, Beta 6 is 8 days distant.
Something, Mr. Spock?
Unusual, Captain. I'm now getting a sizable space displacement reading.
Can you verify that, Navigator?
No, sir. Forward sweeps are negative. Wait, verified, sir. We must be in some sort of light warp or we would have picked it up earlier.
Put it on visual.
Iron silica body, planet size, magnitude 1E. We'll be passing close.
Inconceivable this body has gone unnoted on all our records.
And yet, here it is. No time to investigate. Science stations gather data for computer banks. Uhura, notify the Discovery on subspace radio.
Strong interference on subspace, Captain. Planet must be a natural radio source.
Let's get out of its range. We're 40 degrees to starboard, Mr. Sulu.
40 degrees.
Sulu! Mr. Spock, they're gone!
Emergency. Full reverse power.
Ship's log. Stardate 2124.5. First Officer Spock reporting for Captain James Kirk. We are orbiting the lone, unrecorded planet in the star desert. For 4 hours, we have made every possible instrument sweep. But Captain Kirk and Helmsman Sulu remain unaccounted for. I've placed the ship on red alert.
Searched again from stem to stern. If they're not down on that planet, they're nowhere.
No sign of human life on the surface, sir. Unless the instruments aren't functioning.
Function is normal. Continue sensor sweeps. Lieutenant Uhura, have you checked all wave bands?
All of them, Mr. Spock. No response.
With due respect, sir, request permission to transport to the surface immediately and carry out search.
I second DeSalle's request. What are we waiting for?
The decision will be mine, Doctor. I have the responsibility for your safety. Mr. Yeager, describe your geophysical findings for the surface below.
No detectable soil or vegetation. Extremely hot, toxic atmosphere swept by tornadic storms. Continuous volcanic eruptions. Deadly to any life form such as we know it without oxygen and life support systems.
Estimate survival time of two unprotected individuals down there.
Not very long.
Mr. Spock, look.
Greetings and felicitations. Send this, Lieutenant. USS Enterprise to signaler on planet surface. Identify self.
Yep, yep.
Hurrah. And I believe it's pronounced tally-ho.
Some kind of a joke, sir?
I'll entertain any theories, Mr. DeSalle, any at all.
One thing is certain, obviously, there's life on that planet.
You're quite correct, Doctor. Prepare a transporter room.
Request assignment to the search party, sir.
No, Mr. Scott, neither you nor I can be spared here. Mr. DeSalle, you'll equip the landing party with full communications, armament, and life support gear. Mr. Yeager, your geophysical knowledge may be crucial down there. Dr. McCoy will accompany. If those peculiar signals are coming from Captain Kirk or Lieutenant Sulu, their rationality is in question. Dismissed.